Hi everyone, so finally I am doing the new Petty Peta Eddie Ink Velvet video. Now this one is actually called Ink Eddie Velvet compared to the other packaging, which I'll do a comparison for you guys soon. But I really wanted to show you guys the packaging because you can obviously tell that they have completely changed the look of it. It looks much more sleek, much more like classy looking with that frosty packaging itself on top, I mean around the Eddie Velvet, and also at the back also give you the label. In regards of the wand, is exactly the same as the old Eddie Velvet. It is very hard to find like a decent English review of like what has changed. From what I've heard, it's just changed a little bit of the ingredients, a little bit of the formula, but it's still supposed to be lightweight and satin finish. So it comes out with 5 colors that's supposed to be like your MLBB shade. Now number one is actually like the darker shade, which is Hotspot Red, so obviously for me it's more like a tomato red color. Now let's go back in regards to the texture. It is very very creamy. It's to slide on really easily. It's very like, again, like oily, you know, texture on your face, but it's just slides on so nicely. And the longevity for this one is actually really long lasting. This is actually how it looks like after 9 hours. It did stain a little bit, but it's actually not too bad compared to the Ink Velvet. Again, this is very easy to remove the stain. Number two is Selfie Orange Brown, and it's more like a brownie orange shade for me. In this collection, there's actually 2 different orange shades, so this is number 2, and then number 3 is also an orange shade which you guys will see very soon. Now in regards of the texture, I can definitely see a little bit of the difference. This one feels a little bit heavier than the previous one, but again I feel like I like this consistency more because it's very easy to create that gradient look, and then after that you can do like a fuller lip. It's definitely beautiful, but at the same time there's only so much you can build up, you know. Now unfortunately all of these colors do not match the model itself, which I'm not that disappointed because I expected it to be like that, because I noticed with Petty Pella and a lot of Korean lipstick swatches, they tend to make filter the model you know, lip really like fluorescent, like very vivid looking. So I'm not surprised that it didn't match, but I agree that there's a lot of MLBB shade, which is great. Number 3, it is called Cartoon Coral, so this is obviously like a coral orangey shade. And number 4, this is coral pink, so another it's pretty pink, but for me I call this like a coral pink. I'm actually glad it's not like a fluorescent pink because I like this one on my lips more, because it looks much more down to earth, looks much more warming, but at the same time you see that little hint of coral to it. Now in regards of the scent, is exactly the same. It has like that strong floral scent, which I actually like because later on it does fade away, so that's okay. And so yeah, but from what I can see, a lot of the colors are a little bit different, but at the same time it's very autumn-y for, I guess, yeah, suitable for, you know, the whole season, I guess. But number 5 definitely does not match to me at all. But this one for me is much more of like a rosy sweet pink. When I actually apply this as like a gradient, it does look like a MLBB shade for me, which I really like because it's like my go-to color. And in regards of whether it clings onto my dry patches, it actually doesn't. I do have very dry lips. Now let's do a quick comparison. So this is how the new Ink Eddie Velvet look like compared to the old Eddie Ink Velvet. You see how they changed the name a little bit. Now in regards of the wand, is almost identical. I noticed with the old one, it just look a little bit shorter. Now on my left, I have number 1 to number 5. And on my right, I have number 1 to number 5, the old version. So you can see the colors is completely, completely different. But at the same time, if you ask me which one's my preference, I still love all of the colors, but I'm not sure if they're trying to fade out the older version, which I hope they are not. And here I decided to do like a comparison of the new one to all my other Eddie Ink collection for you guys to see whether the colors are similar. But you can tell that they're not that similar. I mean, like they have like different undertone, but here I'm gonna show you some swatches. So for the new number 2, it is very similar to the old number 8, but number 8 has more of like a brown undertone. Then number 3 new looks similar to number 7, which is much more of a nudie shade, and number 8 is much more of like a brown again. And for the number 4 new, it looks very similar to number 5. Number 5 is much more of like a pinky nudie shade, And then the last one is number 5. It's similar to the old number 10, which is much more of a mauve shade, and number 18, much more of a darker shade. So let's talk about the ratings. I definitely prefer this because it's definitely much more long-lasting pigmentation. I like all the colors, but at the same time, I just didn't like that it didn't match to the model itself, unfortunately. And the moisture, definitely 5 out of 5, because out of all the Eddie Ng collection, I do like this the most. And in regards of the price, again, it's very, very affordable, which, you know, is number, like, thumbs up for that. But overall, I like this collection. I also still like my old collection, and I hope you guys enjoy this review. And if you guys have any more information in regards of this ink Eddie Velvet, I do want to know more, because it's so hard for me to find like an English translation. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I'll see you on my next video. Bye.